And we are happy that he has brought us into the house today. We are giving glory to his name. So I'm happy to see each one of you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So I repeat myself by saying the same thing. And our God is so good. Today is the first day of August 2001. And it is a blessed month because our God takes control. What has he doing? It has been predicted in August there is a demon that normally aligns. There are many deaths, there are many things that take place. And this month we declare it to be the month of a new beginning, the month where the Lord has blessed us, and the month where the Lord has seen us through, in Jesus' mighty name. What has he been? So it is not going to be the month of frustration. It is not going to be the month of failure. It is going to be the month where you see the goodness and the faithfulness of God. And that is our prayer, and that is our faith, and that is how we trust our God in Jesus' name. This month, I decree and declare, you are blessed in Jesus' name. This month, I decree and declare, you have a new beginning in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You have another chance in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You are going up in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You are mounting up in Jesus' mighty name. This is the month where the Lord has blessed you and nothing can bring you down. In Jesus' mighty name. And because it is the first day of the month of August, we are going to read the first verse of the book of Romans, the first verse of the book of Romans, chapter 8. So, Romans chapter 8, verse 1 for the month of August.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, what does it say? Therefore, now, no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. For what law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh, God did by sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, on account of sin, he condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. Verse 5. For those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh, but those who live according to the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. 6. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Because carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, nor indeed can be. So then, those who are in the flesh cannot please God. This was 8. Verse 9. But you are not of the flesh. And he said,
I am not of flesh.
But you are not of the flesh, but of the Spirit. If indeed the Spirit of God dwells in you. Now, if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he is not his. And if Christ is in you, the body is indeed. The body is dead because of sin, but the Spirit is life because of righteousness. But if the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through the Spirit who dwells in you. Therefore, brethren, we are debtors not the flesh to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit You put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, these are the sons of God. For you did not receive the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you received the spirit of adoption, by whom we cry out, Abba, Father. The Spirit Himself bears witness in our spirits that we are the children of God, and if children, then hearers of God, and joint hearers with Christ. If indeed we suffer with Him, that we may also be glorified together. Praise the name of the Lord. We bless the Lord for His work. This day, as we are sharing this word from the book of Romans chapter 8 and verse 1, it came to my mind when I remember that today is the first day. It was put in my spirit when I remember today is the first day of August, or the eighth month. So we have the eighth chapter of Romans to tell us something about or to link it with the month of August. Wherefore we can say, as we see in this word, that there is now no condemnation. In other words, every spirit that is set to condemn you, every spirit that is set to bring you down, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, it needs to know this one thing: there is no condemnation because you are in Christ. So what we see here is there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh. Now, as we look to that word, we see that we are being taught something of what has happened, but there is condition there. There is condition. And when we are told there is no condemnation, there is therefore no condemnation, it follows the condition. So, what is the condition? The condition is to those who are in Christ Jesus. In other words, if we are going to overcome condemnation, if we are going to say we are free, if we are going to say that we are set free, we must remind ourselves, we must see ourselves in the Lord Jesus Christ. Somebody say hallelujah. While Jesus was with you, we must see ourselves in Christ Jesus. So there is a condition there that we do not walk according to the flesh. According to the flesh. Because you know, the flesh fights with the spirit. And the flesh fights with the spirit every day. Let's see 2 Peter 2:11. I remember one time I got a dream and I found myself having that scripture even before I saw it. 1 Peter 2:11. You're not getting it? Is it that one? Okay, thank you. Beloved, I beg you, as sojourners and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lusts, which war against soul. I got that in a dream when I was 18 years, when I got saved. So I woke up very quickly to see what I'm told about that book or that one. Wherefore, it tells us, beloved, I beg you. Beloved, I beg you. Why is he begging them? He's begging them because, Lord, when we gave our lives to Jesus, when we got saved, or Jesus saved us from that sin, the original sin of Adam. That is what made Jesus to go to the cross. Because you could not deliver yourself. You could not help yourself. There is no one who could save you from that sin. That's why we are told that we were all born sinners. And every child who is born is born in that nation of sin. Whether it's born by saved people or not, first of all, they are introduced to that because that is now a person who comes. Because it is not the mother. That is another life. It is another life. Yes, the mother may have repented, the father may have repented, but that child, when the child is born, every one of us were born sinners. That's why the gospel is supposed to be preached, and when we preach to them, reminding them that we were all born sinners. But we, who gave our lives to Jesus, that's where the Bible tells us that we are no longer condemned. If you read the book of John, chapter 16 and verse 18, John chapter 3 and verse 18, 3:18, where it says, he who believes in him is not condemned. He who believes in him, he who believes in Jesus. Now, this kind of believing is not just believing by saying. It is believing by accepting as we have done. So he who believes in him is not condemned. But he who does not believe is condemned already. Is condemned already. In other words, those who have not, those who have believed, you are already delivered. You are delivered from the condemnation of the sin of Adam. But those who have not, they are already condemned. They are in condemnation. Because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. So, when you come back to our text, we find that in chapter 1 of Romans chapter 1, Romans chapter 8 and verse 1, it says, there is therefore now no condemnation. There is therefore now no condemnation. With the condition. If you have done this condition, you have fulfilled this condition. To be in Christ Jesus and to walk, not to the flesh, not according to the flesh. To walk not according to the flesh. Now, what does that tell us? There is that sin. There is that nature of sin. Jesus has dealt with it. Jesus dealt with it in Calvary. But there is also what we call the sin of commission and also the sin of omission. These are the things that we do. These are the sins that we do. Praise the name of the Lord. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Nikirudi kwa Kiswahili, kuna dhambi asili ya dhambi, Yesu alipigana nayo msalabani kwa sababu haukeweza. Haukeweza. Bwana asifiwe. Lakini kuna utendaji wa dhambi, ufanyaji wa dhambi ya kutenda ama ya kutofanya jambo lile ambalo unatakiwa kufanya. Bwana asifiwe. Hilo ni wewe unadiri nayo. Praise the name of the Lord. Kama ni sharati ni wewe unaweza achana nayo.
Bwana asifiwe.
Kama ni hisi ni wewe unaweza achana nayo. Praise the name of the Lord. Wewe ndiye unaweza. Wewe ndiye Help me step ahead. And verse 1. Praise the name of the Lord. While he is of the Spirit.
Releases corruption, and also the spirit that
gives everlasting life. But if you look back to Romans, the book of Romans, chapter 8, then we look at to verse 8. When you see the verse 8, it says, those in the flesh cannot please God. Those in the flesh. So then, those who are in the flesh cannot please God. So those in the flesh come unto ametwika sana mwili. Come unto ametwika sana upande wa mwili hakulalishi Mungu. Lift up your hand and say, Lord, help me to be in the Spirit. In Jesus' name. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. So, yule aliye katika mwili hawezi akamfurahisha Mungu. Na ni vyema tuweze kuomba, tunapoomba tuombe mili yetu. Tujiombe, praise the name of the Lord. Pray that the Lord will help you. On Sunday, kuna mtu mtoto alisema na tukasheka. Akasema habari ya ulafu ama kula sana. Did you know ya kwamba mwili unapoka hivyo, unaliliaga sana chakula. Huyo aliliaga, kuna wakati mwingine unaweza pata na kajaa, katafika chache. Unasikia pana. Pana lazima nipatane na hoteli, pana lazima nipatane na kitu. Lazima nipate kitu. Kwa sababu imekusukuma. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Inakuwa kali. Kama mimi najua kufight na najaribu kufight na kwa sababu najua napenda kula. I'm going to go to the house. Kama sisi ndio alikuwepo akaniona ndarudi mara ya tatu. Baada nikamwita dale. Sasa hivi nimeipenda ile gezeni ninairudia. So nisipo control mimi nakuwa na appetite. Ninakuwa na appetite mingi unless I control. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Wakati mwingine na control na hisi kama ni mateso. Kwa sababu bado nataka kukuma kitu. Praise the name of the Lord. Kwa hivyo unakuta mwili unataka, kuna vitu mwili unataka. Kuna wimbo uliimbwa zamani, wewe unataka kwa nguvu. Bwana asifiwe. Kwa hivyo tusiweze kutoshelesha mwili sana kwa sababu hatutafurahisha Mungu. May God help us in Jesus' mighty name. If you see verse 13, the same book, with verse 13, the same one. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. Declare and say, I refuse to die. In the name of the Lord Jesus. I refuse to die. Unajua, Paulo anasema bila nami upika mwili wako. Kwa sababu anajua mwili, unakwaya mambo mengi sana. Mwili, ndio unakatasaka mtu apende Mungu. Mwili, unakatasaka mtu aongee na Mungu. Pia, mwili unakuwaga na mambo mengi. For if I live according to the flesh, for if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit, now this word if is put there to bring you into making choice. Praise the name of the Lord. The word if is there so that you may be able to choose. Are you of the flesh or are you of the Spirit? Hallelujah. So, that disappeared. You made choice. Hallelujah. You made choice. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the flesh or the deeds of the body. Hallelujah. You put. But if by the Spirit, you put to death. Who put to death?
Verse 16 of the same Romans
8. The Spirit Himself bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. Hallelujah. Si wapendwa waseme haleluya. Okay, number 3. Romans 8:26. It tells us the Spirit also helps us in our weakness. The Spirit helps us in our weakness. The Spirit helps us in our weakness. These are the benefits that we have. And when we have these benefits, we are able to say there is no condemnation. Praise the name of the Lord. Say it again, there is no condemnation.
There is no condemnation.
Why? As if you were.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So, verse 26 says, likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weaknesses. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weaknesses. What does it mean? What else does it mean? Are we saved?
Yes.
Do we have weaknesses?
Yes.
The Spirit helps us in our weaknesses. Say, I am saved.
I am saved.
Lift up your heart up high. Say, I am saved.
I am saved.
I love Jesus.
I love Jesus.
In my weaknesses.
The Holy Spirit
helps me.
In Jesus'
name. So you run back to life because of your weakness. But you allow the Spirit to help you in your weakness. So that you'll be able to fight that sin that easily ends near you. Hallelujah. Because there is that sin that easily ends near you, and it looks in the area of your weakness. It looks in the area where you feel you are weak. But the Spirit gives us that help. The Spirit helps us. The Spirit helps us in our weakness. In our weaknesses, they will be made one as if you were. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So the Spirit will help you.
Just
allow Him to help you in your weakness. Hallelujah. The Spirit helps us. What a spirit. The Spirit helps us. Ah, what a spirit. So when I see a student in you,
those drops from every bottle, that got to Majaza, our mother found us.
We were several boys. Akai, kabla kufunga kofi, alikuwa ameigrab na kulimwaga yote chini. Wale ambao walitaka mimi sikujua ni nini. Sikujua ni nini. Ah, lakini kuna vijana wanataka kunywa. Na walitaka sana. Tulikuwa tukiokoka kujua Yesu. Hata mama yako hakumwaga kwa sababu alikuwa mzuri. Alimwaga kwa sababu ni mzazi. Na hata kama anaiuza. Hata kama anaiuza, angetaka watoto wakunywe. Kwa sababu si kitu kizuri. Praise the name of the Lord. Yeah, ukisikia mtu anatetea pombe, muulize hili swali tu. Muulize, unaweza kunywa na watoto wako? Akisema anaweza kunywa ukiwa ameoza. Kwenye ule ameoza. Lakini kwa kweli wanasema hapana. Ama anakuta sigara. Namwambia, "Mbona unakuta sigara? Kwani sigara ni mbaya?" Alafu namuuliza, "Mtoto wako wa miaka 3 ukimkuta nayo utamuuliza. Ukisikia amesema sitamuuliza, ujue ameoza." Kwa sana naenda ugombe yeye. Lakini akisema ya kwamba nitakashapa ama nitakataza, sasa mwe Bwana Yesu asifiwe. It will be possible for him to hear. Bwana asifiwe. Hey,
ya mwisho,
that is number four. The Spirit Himself makes intercession for us. Ameangalia anaona maua hivi pasta kutoka vizuri. Inasumbua watu kule. Acha nieleke usiku. Thank you. Wow. Sikujua kuweka. Kumbe ni kwa Mungu. Ah, Bwana asifiwe. The Spirit remember this are the benefits. We talked about the benefits that you get from the Spirit because we are under condemnation. We are not condemned since we are in Christ Jesus. So, the Spirit himself made intercession for us. So, if you look to the same verse, 26, part B, it says, for we do not know what we should pray. What we should pray for as we ought. For we do not know what we should pray for as we ought. In other words, we ought to pray. We need to pray. Remember, Jesus said, pray without ceasing. Or men should pray and not lose heart. Men should pray and not lose heart. Or to pray without ceasing. Praise the name of the Lord. We don't be discouraged. Because many times when you pray, sometimes you feel discouraged through the spirit of discouragement coming toward the time of prayer more than any other time. Because at that time you are in the battle. And at that time you have taken the right direction. And the devil wants to fight it. The spirits want to fight it because they don't want to fight you in that light shadow. So when you try to pray, sometimes you feel so discouraged and you feel you're not able to pray. You feel you have no enough words and you try maybe to listen to others and you ask yourself, where are they getting these words? But the Spirit helps us to pray. And in other words, He also intercedes for us. One has it. So the Spirit Himself, what does it mean? Not on behalf, not someone being on behalf of the Spirit, but the Spirit Himself, praise the name of the Lord. The Spirit Himself, the Spirit Himself makes intercession for us. Makes intercession for us. Where does He make these intercessions? He makes these intercessions in the place of prayer. Hello?
One has a few.
Amen.
When the Holy Spirit is praying for you, or is intercedes for you, it is when you are in prayer. When you are not in prayer, that time you are not given Him opportunity to pray for you. Praise the name of the Lord. So, it says, He intercedes, He makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. With groanings which cannot be uttered.
Hapo ndipo unajikuta wakati mwingine umeenda katika roho nyingine. Umeomba, labda umeanza, thank you Jesus, thank you Lord, I have come before you, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Labda unaanza na tanzi. Oh yes Lord, rama mama shaka, kuru kuku shaka kaka, raka raka na mama. Sasa, zile tanzi, zinaanza sasa kukuletea vitu vingine because the Spirit is still working in you. And another groaning sasa. Praise the name of the Lord. These are the groanings of the Spirit. They cannot be uttered. You cannot hear words. But the Spirit prays He intercedes, he makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. With groanings which cannot be uttered. So, these are the benefits. And if we have these benefits, then we confidently say, now, there is no, therefore, there is no condemnation. There is, therefore, no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. Who do what? One has a prayer. They are in Christ Jesus. Who do not walk? Who do not walk according to the flesh? Because the flesh does not pray. The flesh does not know this benefits, but he walks according to the Spirit. Let's stand on our feet. Just open up your mouth and pray. Tell the Lord your God, help me, that I may overcome the things of the flesh. That I may overcome, because you have said to me, when he said to you, he brought you into a place where you can fight and get a success. And remember this, you fight within success. You don't fight outside success, but within success. In Jesus' mighty name, in Jesus' mighty name, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Remember the Bible says, in the book of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 12, and from the days of John the Baptist, until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered fire. And the fire, take it by force. You take it by force in prayer. You take it by force when you pray. You take it by force when you call upon the Lord. You take it by force when you give. You take it by force when you take a step to be found in the house of the Lord. You take it by force when you decide, I am a overcomer. I am a winner. I am not in the flesh. I will not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. In Jesus' name. And you will be able to say, there is no condemnation. There is no condemnation. Just pray. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I bless you. Lord, I lift you. Lord, I need your help. Lord, I say, give me victory in Jesus' mighty name, in the name of the Lord Jesus, that glory may be found in the Spirit and not in the flesh. I call unto me, I call unto you, in the name of the Lord Jesus, let these benefits of the Spirit of God come upon my life, in the name of Jesus. Let life be found in my life. In Jesus' mighty name, let the life of God, in the Spirit of God, be found in me. In the name of the Lord Jesus, let the witness of the Spirit, which speaks to my spirit, tell me who I am and whose I am. Lord, I pray that in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I may live for you and in you. Because I belong to you in Jesus' name. Pray that your Father, the help that we receive from the Holy Spirit, from our witnesses, my Lord, they may be working in my life. Let this help work in my life in the name of the Lord Jesus. So that is I overcome. I overcome the witnesses in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I am not under condemnation. In Jesus' mighty name. And I thank you, Holy Spirit. You pray, you intercede for me. And I thank you, Holy Spirit, winner because you have interceded. I am a winner. You have prayed for me. You have made that intercession for me. I pray in your name and I glorify you in Jesus' name. And to your people, Lord, I speak a blessing in your lives. The blessing of declaring that the month of August, there is no condemnation. The month of August, there is a new beginning. In this August, first day of August, we come to the first pass of Romans chapter 8. And we decree and say, there is now no condemnation for us because of being in Christ Jesus. And we shall not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit of God. My Father and my God, be glorified in the lives of your people, in Jesus' mighty name. Those seeking their bodies, Lord, I pray, healing, 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 in Jesus' name. Kama wewe mgonjwa, inua mkono wako, katika jina la Yesu. Kama kuna jambo lingine unahitaji, just lift up your heart, I pray for you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, these hands that are lifted up, O God, I pray, release the healing for those who need good health. For those who need healing, I declare healing, good health in their bodies. Those who have found a lot of our need, any kind of a need, Lord, I pray, visit them in this need. In the name of the Lord Jesus, let it be done. Let your will be done. Fight for your children. Guide them, dear Father. See them through. We know that your will is your people to be helped by you. We know that your will is that your people may know the Spirit has interceded for them. We know that your will is that we may know that you have helped us in our weakness. We know that your will is for us to know that we have life. Life in Christ Jesus. My Father and my God, I pray that in this life we may see victory, we may see grace, we may see the goodness of the Lord. Bless these people, see them through, lift them up, fill them up by your grace, by your goodness. In Jesus' name, we pray and believe. Let us all say amen. Amen. And amen. In Jesus' name.